Yes, our machine will go up to 60 minutes, but the word is. Yes, you can record, don't worry.
Yeah.
But the word is that if the machine is turned on fully charged, it gives you more than 60 minutes as well. But that's because I haven't started cleaning yet, I haven't put in any attachment over it, so it shows me 71 minutes as battery. Okay, but that, like I said, the machine goes up to 60 minutes. You have more than like about 70 minutes or 75 minutes as well. But we always quote for the shopper 60 minutes on eco mode. Now, what auto mode does is that this is auto mode or medium mode is where the whole intelligence feature comes in. That's where the customer is actually paying the price for. Within the V11 box, you get these attachments. Small attachments are not that, I'll come to that later on. But you get these two attachments mainly as well. This is what we use for actual home cleaning. Does anyone know what the difference is between this one and this one? You guys can look into it. Wet and dry? So we don't make wet and dry vacuums.
What is hot flows and hot fittings.
Okay, which is hot flows? This one?
Floor.
No, this one? Nice. Okay, this one?
Carpets.
What do you guys think?
Hard floor, carpets.
Yeah, absolutely. Wow. This is the soft floor attachment, which is for nothing but hard floors, your tiles, your marbles, whatever wooden surfaces. Mm. This one is actually called the torque drive attachment. I mentioned over here, high torque. The torque drive attachment, which is used for, of course, carpets, if you guys have rugs in your homes, the small mats that people use outside the doorsteps or inside the living rooms. In cleaning with this attachment, okay. Now, obviously, I was just telling them we actually misplaced to get the wand for the demo, So the wand's actually missing. So I'm actually going to give a demo without the wand, right? Oh. So that's actually on our side. I do apologize. So once you keep in the wand over here, okay. Now, the whole intelligence feature of the machine comes in auto mode. Auto mode is the second mode, which gives us how many battery life, how many run time?
40
minutes, right? In auto mode, if you put this attachment, you can clean both carpets and hot tiles. So it's a whole two-in-one feature that comes into play over here. Let's say, ideally, in a normal scenario, you're vacuuming, okay, and you put this attachment in, you're cleaning your carpets over here, but if you have tiles there, you actually have to remove this and keep this in.
No, okay.
But with the V11, you have that two-in-one feature in this attachment itself, which you can just clean carpets and hard tiles directly.
Okay.
That's the intelligence feature that we have over here.
Only in V11, these two attachments are coming, but for the V10, it's not coming.
In the V10, you have two attachments, these four attachments as well, okay. But you won't get this one. It's actually one only for carpets. Okay. This is actually a two-in-one attachment. Okay. Yeah? Okay. This one actually manipulates the suction power over here. We don't have tiles in the store, but if I had to clean a surface, this is normally carpet, right? And from here, if we move to a tile, do you think we need more power for a tile or less power to clean tiles?
Less,
because tiles are much more flatter and carpets are much more rigid.
Yeah.
So when you move it to a tile, well, you automatically have less power from the machine.
Wow.
And it can, of course, conserve battery and clean it properly. However, this can only be used in the second mode, which is auto mode.
Okay.
Yeah? If you keep it in eco mode or boost mode, it won't give you that intelligence feature, that, as we call it. Okay? And how that happens is because how many, we all are humans, we have...
The same feature will work for the auto mode or...
No, it's only because we have a motor over here.
No, okay.
So we have a motor over here that senses the area. We have obviously have a motor over here.
Okay, so there are two motors in this one.
And we have a motor next to the battery as well, which checks the signal as well.
Okay.
There's three motors in the machine. Okay?
How many hours do you have to charge for the battery?
3.5. Who asked? Yeah, 3.5.
And this model is applicable also for like a customer having pets.
Absolutely. You know, I was actually just going to come into that point as well. Yeah, absolutely. I think over here we have people who come to buy vacuums to clean their pet hair, the pet damper. The best tool for that can be the soft roller, depending on the floor type, of course. But more importantly, the mini motorized tool over here. Okay, so this is able to capture not just your pet hair or your pet damper. Where you can clean surfaces like your sofas, your mattresses, your car seats, everything on the outside can be cleaned with this particular attachment. Okay, so to sum it up, this attachment is used to clean what? Is this for? Two in one, right?
Yeah.
Everything. Everything in auto mode. Okay, this attachment is used to clean what?
Tiles,
right? But do we have the two in one feature over here?
No.
Why?
It doesn't have a motor in it.
Exactly. The whole intelligence feature comes over here. Okay. Now this one is used to clean what?
Pet hairs,
okay.
Sofa.
You were saying something?
No, she was.
Okay, you were saying.
Sir, what is the purpose of that plus
this one?
Minus? No, that one.
This one?
Plus minus? Yeah.
Okay. The plus minus is used if you have a large debris around. Let's say you have carpets over here. We don't have dust, right? So, ideally, let's say if we have a lot of cereal or like lentils, it's very, very thick and big. If it's across here, you can use plus minus to increase the suction power over here. So over here we have a rubber surface at the bottom. If you have a large debris, and that means you need more space to vacuum, put the plus sign over here. If we have a small debris, put the minus sign over here. So it cleans the. So if I put plus, this has opening over here, so it creates that suction vacuum inside. But if you put minus, it can create a smaller space over here. This feature is not that crucial as well, but for your information, we use this if you have like a very thick pile of dirt surrounded in your area. Okay.
The sensing power will be same. Suppose.
It doesn't matter at all. So basically, if you guys can come down over here, if I put minus over here, if I put plus, it just creates a different surface area over here to vacuum.
Mm-hmm.
That is it. It's like the opening is changed.
Only for high endless.
That's it. The suction power is the same, but just that the way it takes in the dirt is just changed. That's it. Okay. Now this attachment is called the mini motorized tool. All right. This is one of my personal favorite attachments as well. I use it almost every single day. This can be used to clean your rugs. You know, people have thick Persian rugs at their home, especially Arabs, which are very, very thick and very, very delicate. Your mattresses, your sofas, your car mat, your car seats as well. You can clean with this as well. Now, the interesting feature about this attachment is that let me turn it on for you guys. Can you keep your hand flat like this? You see how it's very rigid and this captures everything over here? You feel that turdiness?
Like not something.
Don't worry, this is sanitized, don't worry. Yeah, so what happens? It has these carbon fiber filaments inside. Is able to capture the deepest of dirt inside your mattresses. So the best experiment is, once you guys have a fixture as well, you will have an area to vacuum that fixture.
Okay.
Remove the bin, fully empty, and just vacuum across. If you have seats in the office, if you have like a sofa anywhere, just vacuum over it. You see the amount of dirt that's captured by the machine over here.
Okay.
Because dirt is something you and I can see, and there's some dirt which we can't see as well. So what we do is we make the invisible visible over here. So the day you guys have a vacuum cleaner, or if you guys have a sofa, just vacuum over it, and you see the amount of dirt that's piling up over here. It always works for me. That's the best demo I advise my staff as well to do with two customers or on their surfaces. So this is the mini motorized tool. Perfect for cleaning sofas, mattresses, car seats, car mats, or any type of rug as well. Okay? I will come into the bin bit later on as well, don't worry. Yes, we have a wand which we forgot to bring today. But this is actually a tool. You can clean
curtains.
Your air ducts over there. If we have corners over here, which you can't
corners, corners.
Clean that surface as well. If you have at the side of your car, which is always tough to reach, put the crevice tool to clean corners and hard to reach surfaces.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Crevice tool is done. This is what we call as a combination tool. Now this tool, can you hold this? This tool has a function where you can go down or you can go up as well. Okay, that's why it's called a combination tool. This tool can be, you see the coating over here are nylon bristles. In this way. Okay. Now these two tools are very, very similar, but it just depends on what your needs. Surfaces are much more softer over it. Can you feel the difference between these two? Soft?
Yeah,
hard, right?
Yeah.
Feel it? Which one is soft? This one, right? And you feel that there is also a coating over here?
Yeah, I did that.
So, what did you do of that video? So long?
Alright, because this tool is quite soft for us to use, you can use it to clean your TV screens. If you have tabletops, which are very, very docking station actually, which we don't have. Do we have it, Elmo? Docking station?
For charging.
Yeah. Alright. Okay. We also have a docking station, which is basically a wall mount. You can just put two screws, which comes in the box, two screws, and you can hang the vacuum like this.
Mm. Yeah, docking station come with all the models or only
all models. Ideally, let's say people use their vacuums, so you can charge it like how we charge your phone. Connect it, put this in, charged. But also, if people like to have it much more clear, people like to show off as well sometimes.
Yeah,
just keep it over here. You put the wall mount in, two screws, you're good to go. The wall mount also holds four attachments as well. Any questions? Sorry, I didn't ask you. Okay, how do you clean the filter, and does anyone know about? So you just take, remove the filter and as I showed you, put regular water, okay? No liquid, please don't use sanitizer, nothing. Just let it run into tap water, let it dry fully. Has to be fully dried, keep it back in. You're good to go. Okay? But guys, please make sure if it's not fully dried, what will happen is if you put dirt in water, it'll be clogged up. So then you get bad smell, everything floating around somewhere. Alright, so let's say you clean the filter, you kept it back in, but you didn't do it properly. Now I turn it on, it says filter non sealed. Correct? It says over here filter non
sealed. It's an
error. It also tells you what's wrong with the machine at this point. But over here, it shows you exactly what's the issue over here. There's an animation that shows you that it tells you first filter not sealed, and then there'll be an animation that tells you please turn
fix
the filter.
Properly, yeah.
I should hire you as a photographer next time, man. Yeah, I'll hire you, don't worry. Alright, so that's one of the features as well. It tells you what's wrong and what's missing. Now, the bin size is 760 ml. Okay, that's the bin size over here, 760 ml. Okay? Mm-hmm. If I had so much debris and I haven't cleaned it, I have a vacuum cleaner, I never throw the dirt out, I'm so lazy. So sometimes it tells me that, okay, fine, you have to. This part tells you the bin needs to be emptied over here. Because there's so much dirt inside, the machine can't take in more dirt, then it will just be clogged up. Then what will happen is there are high chances of your dirt going inside over here, being stuck over here, it's machine is clogged up. Then the best thing you have to do is tell the customer to remove it as I showed you over here. Which is why I'm pressing this, the one button over here, clean it, dry it, good to go. Yeah, you guys want to try it? There you go. Clean up this area as well. Now guys, the reason why I'm focusing a lot on maintenance as well is because it's the same logic if you have an expensive phone. Today, let's say you guys bought an iPhone 12 and you guys just don't charge it properly, you guys just maintain it, just step on it, you know, it'll be damaged eventually. The same logic over here, if you're buying an expensive gadget, which is obviously a Dyson premium machine, you have to maintain it the right way as well. Well, how to clean your filters and everything of that sort. Yeah? You have 7 as well, okay. But you do not have the carpet to.